Alright, hello everybody, and welcome to Let's Play Black Mesa. A lot of talking to do, you know the rule, you know the drill. I'm going to be talking about my background with this game, why I'm playing this game, and just a few other details. Now for starters, I don't know why. I mean, because I always used to have a problem with juggling so many games and so many LPs at once. And yes, I understand that can probably be quite annoying for the viewers. But then it seems like because I want to play it so bad, I always make up an excuse. And yes, my excuse for this is that this technically is a game I've wanted to LP for a long time and was always planning on doing it. So yeah, still not a valid excuse. Let me take a drink quick. My throat is very, very dry. Oh, nice grape soda. Oh, very nice. Not so good on the throat, but it tastes very nice. Water is very good on the throat, but grape tastes a lot better than water because water doesn't really have a flavor. Anyways, now for starters, I've been up for quite a while. My last session of Minecraft, which was played around 3 p.m. yesterday, when I recorded that and uploaded that, it said it was uploaded today on whatever the number for today is, the 14th. But I actually recorded it on the 13th. It's just that I recorded until basically 10, and it takes a while for YouTube to process the videos. It takes a little over an hour usually, so it ended up being sometime around midnight by the time that the videos were finished and uploaded, which is why it says so. Most of my LP videos are always uploaded the day after it says, even though they were kind of uploaded in the same day. So I might be a little bit loopy. Well, I'm not saying I'm going to be a bit loopy, but I'm wide awake right now because I've been waiting to play this game for ages. I've stayed up all night just specifically to play this game, or at least get a little far into it. Hopefully, at least make a little progress. Now, this is also going to be a new kind of Let's Play that I've not really done too much yet, and that is a continuous Let's Play to an extent. Black Mesa is not a finished game. It does not have the final chapter, the Zen chapter. None of that is in the game yet. Alright? So I will play from there, from the beginning up to the final part of the game, which will, in this, will be the final chapter, and then when they add the Zen update, I will play that and do more of the LP, meaning that if we reach the final chapter right now that's currently available before the Zen update is released, it won't be marked finale like most of my end LP ones are, or end of the LP is. We'll be waiting for the Zen to come around to do that. Right now they're focusing quite a bit on multiplayer content. I mean, I even looked at the latest patch notes. They changed some of the different models and fix some bugs for single player and stuff like that, but the thing is it's mostly focused on multiplayer. However, what is my background with Black Mesa and why am I wanting to play it? Well, for starters, if you have watched my previous Half-Life related games, you should watch them way before you do this. Okay, I did an LP on Half-Life, Half-Life Blue Shift, Half-Life Opposing Force, Half-Life Decay, Half-Life 2, Half-Life 2 Episode 1, Half-Life 2 Episode 2, Half-Life 2 Lost Coast. I did pretty much everything Half-Life I could get my hands on. In the Decay, we had to play basically an emulator kind of thing. Me and a friend, which is from the PlayStation 2, I believe, and that was actually quite fun to play co-op. However, where does Black Mesa fit in, and why did I bring up the fact that I did those? Well, Black Mesa is where it all started for me. That's how I was introduced into the Half-Life universe of things. As I stated in my first Half-Life Let's Play, I'd assume, Black Mesa is where it all started. Now, sometime in 2012, when Black Mesa was released as a mod, that basically what this game is it completely is to convert Half-Life into the Source engine with updated graphics, models, gameplay, updated everything. All right, now I had played it through in one day. Yeah, I loved it that much, right? But back then there was no Zen update either. However, here's the thing, that was so long ago that I didn't, even when I went to play the normal Half-Life game, I didn't remember And most of the stuff I had experienced in the Black Mesa mod. And I had played that mod through, shit, I don't remember what that thing's called, starts with a D. It's kind of like Steam, I think it starts with a D. I can't remember, but that's where I had to play the mod through. And I thought, and the reason I did that was because I didn't have money to purchase the Half-Life at the time. And a group of friends that introduced me to it, that then ruined Half-Life 2 for me, basically told me, hey, look, there's this mod, Black Mesa, it's not fully completed yet, but it's kind of like playing a free Half-Life. And so that's exactly what I did. And though I remember pretty much absolutely nothing, in fact, to be honest, it's been so long, and since I've played through all the Half-Life games, I don't remember a single thing from this. I don't remember what anything looked like, where anything was, anything like that. This is basically going to be a blind Let's Play, and that's why it is going to be titled Blind. Now, but here's the thing. This is why it is going to be a nostalgia, cool remake, nostalgia. Now, it's going to be nostalgic because, number one, I do remember one thing from back when I played it, that because everything is so updated and graphically intense compared to the 1998, I think, Half-Life, you get to see more detail. And because it's a 90s-based game, you get to see how everything looks very 90s. And because that's the years I was born, a lot of stuff around there really gives me some nostalgic value, like the computers, and various different types of things, basically, and vehicles and kind of stuff like that. So it's going to be nostalgic in that way, because I remember feeling very nostalgic when playing Black Mesa previously. So it'll be nostalgic both for the fact that it'll remind me of back in the day, and it will also remind me of Black Mesa. But it's also going to be kind of nostalgic in that I might remember stuff from the original Half-Life that we played not too long ago, or finished not too long ago. But the main thing is so much is changed in this game that I might not even recognize it from Half-Life, and that's just one of the cool things about it. So without further ado, I guess we should get in. I'm super excited. Hopefully the audio is good. Oh, my thingy fell off the desk. My bad. It was starting to fall off there. Put my little rubber hand. All right, new game, play game. Ouch. 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 Black Mesa. Boobs. Ominous music. Oh god, no. Black Mesa inbound. That's fantastic, but first, let me take a selfie. Oh shit, we gotta flip the difficulty onto normal, please. Audio, no, that's fine in the video. Mouse, okay. Oh, yeah, much better, okay. Wow, look at this. It looks nothing like Half-Life, it just doesn't.
Good morning, and welcome to the Black Mesa Transit System.
He's waving.
This automated train is provided for the security and convenience of the Black Mesa Research Facility personnel. The time is 8:47 a.m. Current topside temperature is 93 degrees, with an estimated high of 105. The Black Mesa compound is maintained at a pleasant 68 degrees at all times.
Wow, this is fantastic. When we end our tour here, I've got some details to talk about that I've noticed on the inside here, but I don't want to do it now because I'm afraid she's going to interrupt and I don't want to interrupt her. Loading times are fantastic. It already feels nostalgic. As if I'm thinking back to the Half-Life. Oh, there's one other thing. Oh, God, look at this.
Train is inbound from Level 3 dormitories to Sector C test labs and control facilities. If your intended destination is a high-security area beyond Sector C, you will need to return to the central transit hub in Area 9. and board a high security train.
Wow.
If you have not yet submitted your identity to the retinal clearance system, you must report to Black Mesa personnel for processing before you will be permitted into the high security branch of the transit system.
Oh, wow, it's not a 2D background out there. Look at this!
Due to the high toxicity of material routinely handled in the Black Mesa compound, no smoking, eating, or drinking are permitted within the Black Mesa transit system.
Holy shit! Oh, I remember this part from the original game, but it looked nothing like this.
The train at all times. Do not attempt to open the doors until the train has come to a complete halt at the station platform. In the event of an emergency, passengers are to remain seated and await further instruction. If it is necessary to exit the train, disabled personnel should be evacuated first. Please stay away from electrified rails and proceed to an emergency station until assistance arrives.
Oh god, guys. Oh, look at this. This is military... Like, see, you didn't have all this kind of shit in the original. It's so fantastic how people were able to remake this shit. Oh, I remember these doors where the three things open. And he actually walks over to open up the doors, too. Look at that. Look at the textures! Holy shit! I don't know why I'm fanboying over this. Again, I'll explain more about kind of why once the train comes to a full stop. Oh, yep, we gotta wait for it to close. Oh, yes, the lights are turning on.
A reminder that the Black Mesa Hazard Course Decathlon will commence this evening at 1900 hours in the Level 3 facility. The semifinals for high security personnel will be announced in a separate secure broadcast transmission. Remember, more lives than yours may depend on your fitness. Have a friend or relative who would make a valuable addition to the Black Mesa team? Immediate openings are available in the areas of materials handling and low clearance security. Please contact Black Mesa personnel for further information. If you have an associate with a background in the areas of theoretical physics, biotechnology, or other high-tech disciplines, please contact our civilian recruiting team. The Black Mesa facility is an equal opportunity employer.
Oh, wow, guys, I am really blown away by... Look, we got two guys walking away back there. You can actually see the floor. Unlike in the original. What the hell? Oh, no, I think we're gonna go down. Yeah.
A reminder to all Black Mesa personnel. Regular radiation and biohazard screenings are a requirement of continued employment in the Black Mesa Research Facility. Missing a scheduled urinalysis or radiation checkup is grounds for immediate termination. If you feel you have been exposed to radioactive or other hazardous materials in the course of your duties, contact your radiation safety officer immediately. Work safe. Work safe.
Oh, I see you back there, asshole.
Your future depends on it. Now arriving at Sector C test labs and control facilities.
Oh, well, you could see some of the floors at least.
Please stand back from the automated door and wait for the security officer to verify your identity. Before exiting the train, be sure to check your area for personal belongings. Thank you, and have a very safe and productive day.
Morning, Mr. Freeman.
Why, hello.
Looks like you're running late.
So hold on. All right, one thing I did want to say is I think I was able to play Black Mesa through Steam, but through that mod thing. So I think if you look way back, I actually have a few screenshots on my Steam from way back when I played it, I think. Could be wrong. I don't know. But one of the first things I noticed is, are the voices redone? Like, are they redubbed or are they just remastered? Because they kind of sound almost redubbed. But one of the other things is, one of the great things about this, you know, about Black Mesa is that from before, which I'm sure it looked fantastic for the time, you weren't able to see little details like this. You didn't see shit like transit authority, Sector C line with various different security things and labs, and I'm sure you didn't see like over here you've got this thing that says priority seat for people who are disabled, pregnant, or less able to stand. You know, shit like that. Secure sector station. So I might be looking at a lot of this stuff. Like, what do we got down here? Team acquires new grant. It's very hard to tell. Well, all right, Mr. Security Dude.
You know, Barney's been pretty scarce around these parts.
Oh, he has. I know who that is.
Bar tab must have finally caught up with him.
So nice to hear about. Oh, look at these! Look at these little panels. They actually have detail in them. Look at that.
Put some pep in that step, Freeman. You're late enough as it is.
Security present. Present your ID to security officer on duty. And look at the detail in that. Like, holy shit. Look at this. Compared to how it always was.
Aw, man, you cut the ponytail. Sell out.
I guess I used to have a ponytail. And I know some stuff has changed, so it doesn't...
I had a bunch of messages for you, but we had a system crash about, 20 minutes ago, and I'm still trying to find my files. Just one of those days, I guess. They were also having some problems down in the test chamber, too, but I think that's all straightened out. They told me to make sure you headed down there as soon as you got into your hazard suit.
Roger that. I think, some of the rooms have changed. I think that's what it said on one of the... the lines.
Security officer Murphy, please report to office complex level 6, conference room A.
I am gonna take my time with this. Can't mess with that.
Get away from there.
What?
I'm expecting an important message.
This kind of shit wasn't there before, was it?
Gordon, don't touch that.
Fuck you.
Go use another computer.
Oh, damn it, he's pissed off. But look at that. What? So, because it's the source engine, I can pick shit up. I can pick shit up and throw it.
so you better make it count.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do it. Look, it's the Windows crash thing! Can I take the computer off the thing? No, I can't cause that much damage. I can take that. That, whatever that was.
What are you doing still running around up here?
I'm wasting time.
Gordo, you're on sundial and we need you on stopwatch. Up to it.
There's a buton. Push to trigger emergency alarm.
Hey, it's happening!
Cut it out!
What the hell is going on up there?
My horoscope was correct.
Did someone pull this fire alarm or something?
Come on, Gordon. What are you trying to do? Get me into trouble?
I got an achievement!
yeah, I'm here. We had a little accident up here, sorry.
Yeah, well, that better be the last accident you have today. Understood?
I copy. Damn, Gordon.
Oh my god, it's so much more immersive. Oh wow, okay. So we've got... Can I move the chair? No, I wanted to look at the keyboard.
Coded message for...
Try hitting Control-Alt-Delete.
Command?
Quit looking over my shoulder, you're making me uncomfortable.
So I noticed while I was over there that the keyboard... I know I'm taking a lot of time, but I'm going to take my sweet-ass time with this game, guys.
Agent Allen, report to administration, sub-level 2.
Hello?
Hello.
I'm rather busy now.
Of course you are. But I noticed on this thing over here...
Just a minute, Gordon.
That the keyboards are... Look at that. You can see each key. I don't know. It's just so mind-blowing because it's... Imagine if this is what came out. You know, like right after as a texture update or something.
Good morning, Dr. Freeman. Leak earlier, but the thermal protection system seems to be online now. Those TPS reports have gotten progressively worse. Hard to find good help these days. Yes, about that. We're going to need you to come in this weekend. What? I've already made plans. Don't worry. You can always attend the next convention.
What? What's going on, man?
Drat.
There's a debugging procedure coming.
If only I could read their lips. Oh boy.
Doctor?
He's looking.
Report to anomalous materials test lab.
What? Asshole! Excuse me, you were talking about finger smudge.
Still studying paleomathematics, eh?
You forgot to carry the 2, or was it the 3?
Oh, bloody fuck, what the hell are you guys doing here? Look at this. Look at all of the detail in that. Like, people had to make this shit. I don't know who would have the patience to do that. Can I play, like, Donkey Kong or something?
Be a calculator. You're insane. Completely insane.
I apologize.
I don't know about that, Dr. Truman. Seems to me that he's just spouting buzzwords in his research papers that he picked up from perusing popular scientific periodicals.
Oh, wow.
Can this wait?
Yeah, they definitely had to have added in new voice things and stuff. Sector B.
Got the wrong airlock, Mr. Freeman. You know I can't let you through here.
Oh, look at the first aid thing! It looks like an updated version of... I think it was, Oh god, what the hell was it? No, I don't think it was... There was... I don't know, one of the games had, like, an updated version over the original, which is just the 2D texture. What have we got in here?
Oh, would you look at that! Freeman actually did show up for work this morning. Looks like somebody here owes me lunch.
Wow.
Shut up.
What? I don't remember that shit happening in the original. That's hilarious how that her laugh is funny.
Big day today, eh, Freeman?
Yeah. It's a big day.
Yep. There's a pepperoni pizza in mine.
That's a good choice, man.
Gordon.
Yes, go choke on it.
Have more important things to be doing.
Yeah. But I'm exploring.
Just sent down to the test chamber.
Okay. We'll get to that sample in a minute. Don't you worry.
Good morning, Gordon.
Good morning.
Gonna get me one of them jumbo size Retta grape sodas.
God, they must have added so much shit. Camera 4 feed is offline. Yeah, there's so much detail here. Oh, God, guys, if they release DLC for this. Oh, one thing that I also forgot to mention. Oh, yeah, here's the other thing I wanted to talk about was that I love Half-Life so much. It's mainly just the first one, though I like the other ones as well. I think Half-Life is really where it sits for me. That's my favorite. I love the story so much, and I just love the game. So to see it all like this is almost as if I had played it years and years back, and I'm now playing it back in updated form. That's kind of what it feels like. However, one of the other things was is... One thing I did say was the reason it did take me very long to actually get my hands on this game is because it's $19.99 on Steam, and I picked it up when it was on sale during the Christmas things. So yeah, now that we have it, we can do this shit.
You're living in the past. That experiment is single-handedly responsible for inspiring my career in science.
How much recognition do you think you're going to get for reproduction, though?
You should focus on inventing something new and unique.
He does have a point.
Oh, but this is more than a replication, I assure you. For one, it shows how far our field has come since the original study was published, and to say nothing of the modern perspective necessary to monitor its influence. I mean, combined with today's technology, I've recreated...
Bah. I can't stand to hear another word of this malarkey.
Don't mind him, but here's something to think about for the next time.
You and your sugar-coated air socks are absolutely full of it.
Creativity is the art of hiding your influence. Now let's get back to work. We should at least try to look busy.
The animations and this kind of shit, because I'm pretty damn sure we didn't have this kind of shit before. I'm pretty damn sure. Oh God, that was very loud. Uh-oh.
Morning,
you know,
Jim.
This room.
Hello?
Hello? No, I want this can.
Another day, another dollar.
Oh, God.
Good heavens!
What the hell?
It didn't explode, did it?
You think you can fix the vending machine too, college boy?
We will never hear the end of this.
Yeah, you'd best make like an atom and split. Because that was, that was you-know-who's lunch.
Uh-oh. Wasn't it... In the original game, it made a big splatter. Who's you-know-who?
I'm just better than you.
Oh, fuck you, man.
Freeman, please.
Peckish? Enjoy something. I'm trying to break this one. Look at the detail in that! I just now realized you can see the shit! What have we got in here? We've got Ramblers, which is obviously a Lay's thing. Various different Ramblers. Uppercuts. I'm not exactly sure what kind of brand that's supposed to be doing. The fries, that's like the baked fries. Oh, that's Ramblers as well.
Can you access the mail server?
Various different candy bars. I'm not sure I can recognize any of them. Wow, that... Oh, God, the detail in this is amazing. Can I...
Have you seen my coffee cup?
Have you... Your coffee cup. Hold on. Your coffee cup's right there, you dumbass.
Gordon, you've already done enough damage here. Get to work.
Oh, I was trying to pick up your damn coffee
cup.
Believe
you me, I won't be taking the blame for this one.
I'm pretty sure... I thought in the first game that they... We saw that, and it exploded. And, the guy was sitting where the woman is, I thought.
What's the extension for technical support?
Because really, before, there wasn't any real women around, was there? I don't think. Not really, too much.
Why do we all have to wear these ridiculous ties?
No idea, man, no idea.
Triple pleated khakis. Preposterous.
I can't open any of these people's shit.
Drat. No toilet paper.
What?
Be a dear and fetch me a roll of toilet paper. Hello? Hello? Could somebody get me some toilet paper?
Toilet paper. Here you go.
Excuse me.
Here.
Minor emergency.
Here.
Oh, thank heavens.
I got an
achievement. I'm in dire need of some toilet paper.
Well, there you go, man. Can't open up these. They say vacant, but I can't open them. Can I turn this on? Nice. My health. I can't take. I can take. I don't know what this is. It's like paper towel or something. I can't do anything with that. Can't go in there. Can I open any of these? Oh, my Freeman one. We'll take a look at that in a minute. Because I don't think I can pick that up with the... Oh, yes.
To the HEV Mark IV protective system. For use in hazardous environment conditions. Automatic medical systems engaged. High impact reactive armor activated. Atmospheric contaminant sensors activated. Vital sign monitoring activated. Automatic medical systems engaged. Defensive weapon selection system activated. Munition level monitoring activated. Communications interface online. Have a very safe day.
Wow, this is great. I almost want to cry. Empty, the charge is empty. Oh, look at that. That is fantastic. Can't open up. Gillen, Rose, whatever that one is. Wilson. Wilson! Fuck that shit. I have Gordon Freeman assigned thing, and I have a picture of a baby, and I have a coffee mug, which did not break. Can I open up any of these? Stone? Yank? Oh, I thought it said wank.
Hazardous environment suit.
Oh, do you?
Of course, at the time, it was Mark III.
Ah.
Mind you, the base color wasn't so loud.
Okay.
And the helmet wasn't optional, or ventilated. There wasn't an integrated waste disposal system, either. Count your lucky stars.
This stuff's great! You didn't get this shit in the original!
Have you ever seen those electromyographic sensors in the old biomechatronic Mark I? A marvel of modern engineering. I worked on the underwater breathing apparatus for the suit, but it was eventually discarded.
Aw, that would be great.
I say, that suit certainly flatters your fundament.
Oh.
You'll just have to wait until after the test. Later, Gordon.
Okay. I don't think you can open any more of these. I thought maybe you could. No. Okay.
They don't just give any old riffraff off the street the honor of wearing that lab coat, Gordon.
Yeah. Oh god, it's just as fast paced as the other ones, though.
Don't count on it. If anything, you'll just have more to do.
Yeah, you're gonna have a lot more to do. Oops, I did not mean to grab that.
Weren't you supposed to be in the test chamber half an hour ago?
Yep.
Just hold on for a moment.
Yep. What about piss ass over here?
I'm only going to explain this to you one more time. If you have a question, that isn't my problem. It's yours. Right. And if I have a question,
it isn't my problem.
Au contraire. It is still, very much so, your problem. Now, do we have a problem? No. Really? I don't see a cup of coffee with two sugars and no cream in my hand. Do you?
No.
Well, that looks like a problem to me.